Calling O Trunks, Mario and company followed the Floro Sapiens underground. What's the hideout of the Floro Sapiens just up ahead? Wow, it's dark and narrow. Hey, who just kicked me? Sorry, all me. Our heroes followed the long, dark corridor, listening to echoes of their own voices. As they groped their way along, the light at the end of the tunnel grew brighter. They had finally arrived at the inner sanctums of the Floro Sapiens. The Kragnons kidnapped from downtown of Krag had to be just around somewhere. Chapter 5-3, A Krag in the Dark. No introduction, just straight to the point. Let's go ahead and do it. Alright then, so the next two levels are going to be really, really puzzly. There's a bunch of, it's really easy to get lost in these next two levels, especially if you haven't done them in a while. Coming to you live from the foul darkness that the Floro Sapiens call home, lesser Kragnons would weep softly. No one has set foot in his cave and emerged alive, but some make history with cheer, gal, and willpower, and Flint Craggly is such a man. Craggly, ho! Into the Floro Sapiens cave of doom, and Flint Craggly, Craig, trotting adventure. Okay. No, wait a second. Got another play well in the sticks. How about Craggly Ho? Taste danger. Flint Craggly versus a recragnated mummy in Floro Sapiens Central. I wonder if that'll test well with the weakened audience. Those Kragnons are I don't even know what the last one he said. Craggly Ho! Suddenly, out of the cave mists, mysterious slavering creatures lurch into view. Slavering creatures? Okay, this guy's strange. You're on a quest to find a treasure called the Pure Hearts. Spectacular, just fabulous, all-time coincidence, that's what this is. Just great to meet fellow adventurers, really it is. I'm ecstatic about it. Okay, so this guy's name is Flint. Best Krag Trotter of our time. Okay. Flint Kragly, Krag Trotter. Okay, so he has a news, that airs weekly on the Krag Vision. You're pretending to be kidnapped? Okay. So unprofessional. Yep. Really? Wow. Okay. All right then. Time to look for some crew members. That's the objective of this level. So let's go ahead and do that. And finding them can be a bit of a pain. As you can see, we have a locked door. That must be what the key that he's talking about is for. Alright, so we have a save block there, which you probably want to save, because this is a bit of a longer level than usual. Especially for a third level. Over here, we have a bomba wall with an area. So let's see what we got going on here. Okay, nothing up here. There's nothing special of some sort, but we have a bunch of coins. Alright, that's pretty cool. And we're actually about to be maxed out on coins, so that's just wonderful. Alright then. Well, that's pretty interesting to see there. So let's see what else we got going on here. I think there's something falling on top of me. Nope, there's not. Okay, so we actually have spike tops. Blue spike tops, that's pretty strange, but yeah, spike tops they're pretty much buzzy beetles that have spikes on their heads. Is there anything that we can find? Oh god, okay. Those are Kragnons. They will actually kill you. You can kill them if you want, but let me just tell you right now, it's not worth killing them at all. So just trust me on that. Alright, so as you can see, as soon as we come to this area is gonna be exactly the same as in in level 2-1 from Super Mario Brothers. So, if you played Super Mario Brothers, then this part of the level should not be hard at all. That's pretty cool. I can't use my pixels while I'm using Boomer. That's a shame. Dang it, dude! Okay. Hey, I just got 2 mushrooms, man. What is going on now? That's kind of... That's something that you don't usually have happen, I think. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. Anyway, so we have a returning enemy from the Thousand-Year Door. We have, what are those enemies called? Spanyas. And Spanyas, they're really weak enemies, so you can easily, shouldn't be too hard of enemies to deal with. Oh gosh, okay. Oh my god, please. Okay, now I'm just getting myself destroyed. And then we have Slow Flower. Oh my god, I got poisoned. And I just missed out on 1,000 points. Because I'm a scrub at this game. Ugh. Okay, well. I will go back to whatever the heck I just missed. So don't worry about me, guys. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and deal with these enemies now that I can. Alright, it's probably faster at this point since carry. Yeah. What did you just drop? Okay, well, that's weird. I'll take that. Ow. Alright. Yeah, when the Buzzy Beetles are... Even though firepower does not work against them, if you use, if Boomer while they're in their shell, then they will... Whoa, okay. Then they will die. And a fresh veggie fell down. That's unfortunate. Okay. Anyway, back to where. So this is where I missed a bunch of stuff. Oops. I just want to get points. I'm not greedy, I hope. Okay. Hit this block right here, and you'll get something pretty cool. Okay, so just like in Super Mario Brothers, we have a bunch of coins that you could get here, but I am just gonna pass over them because I am already maxed out on coins, so I have no reason to do that at all. All right, you can blow this up right here, and you get yourself a door. Wow, that's not fair. Hit me during a cutscene? It's kind of a shame. Okay, so there's a door that I skipped over, and that is over here. So let's go ahead and take a look at what's in this door. Okay, so here, this is probably my favorite part of the level. We get to take a ride in this minecart, which is really awesome. I love riding this thing, man. I used to mess around with this thing a lot when I was playing this game for the first time. It was just really awesome. Okay, so funny thing is, on my first playthrough, I thought I was gonna run to those walls until the car decided to turn around. I was like, oh my god, this is the coolest minecart ever. I would love to ride this. But no, it'd just be the same experience as riding a roller coaster, and I don't have good experiences with roller coaster riding. Yeah, I'm pretty bad with roller coasters, as you probably may guess. I'm pretty sure I told the story before, but I don't really like roller coasters that much. They just give me a headache after riding on a few roller coasters. I rode on like five roller coasters during my 8th grade trip, and I just felt. I didn't feel too good after that, so I was with a group of friends, and at the time, during that trip, and then they wanted to ride on a bunch of roller coasters, and basically, after riding on like a few roller coasters, like they wanted to ride on more roller coasters after that, but then at that point, I was already feeling not so good. So every time they want to ride on a roller coaster, I just sit back and just wait for them to be done. And I did bring my camera, so I was recording a blog for my blog channel, which at that point I still have that video on my vlog channel. Yeah, I still have that on my vlog channel, but it's private at the moment, which I actually don't know why I private it. I made it private. I probably should unprivate now. But I mean, most of my vlogs at the time are pretty well. I mean, look at my vlogs at now to this current day. I think I did a pretty bad job with those vlog videos. So I'm just, which is, and I guess that's the reason why I privated them earlier. But oh well, it's not. Maybe someday I'll bring them back. If some of you guys want it. Oh well, I don't really, the friends that I went to that trip on with, I actually don't really have much communications with them anymore. Or at least not the communications that I used to have with them. I don't really have that anymore. It's kind of a shame that would, because I really should. But oh well. I mean, things happen, gotta move on, and etc. So anyway, going to that door, you have a triangular prism of coins, which I don't need because I am already maxed out coins. So any coin that you see me get at this point are accidental, because I don't really need that many coins at this point. It's just useless now. Okay, I swear to you. Okay, good. Okay. All right. So what you just missed out was me finding the first crew member out of the two that we have to look for. So we have to go ahead and look for the next one. So let's see where the next one could be found. Actually, on my first playthrough, I actually had the hardest time looking for these guys. Playing this game now, I still kind of have an issue with them, with finding them. But I don't know. I guess at the time I've never really played Super Mario Brothers. It wasn't easy for me to recognize 2-1 until I started playing the game again a few playthroughs later. Maybe that's why I used to get stuck in this level a lot. I don't know. I used to get stuck at a lot of things in this game when I played this game for the first time, and then a few playthroughs later. I used to get stuck at a lot of places. I actually don't know why. Probably because, as I said in the beginning of the Let's Play, that I had no common sense. That might be the best reason to describe it. And what do you know? Guess what? Here's the next crew member. You're not mind controlled. You escaped from processing center. What is processing center? That must be an area that we'll be encountering later on. You know, director. So that was where he was. He told Monzo, "Wait here." But Monzo, but he forgot 1 second later. Job of Monzo, really lame. Thanks, bro. Monzo, head back now. That's Monzo. I don't know what the other guy's name was. Not that it matters anyway. Anyway, so we have more of these guys, and there's nothing much you can see here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and have you? If you look at these guys and look at the regular Kragnons, you can see that these guys' backs—they're just like they just look like old. Their backs are just—they look like old people with their backs like that. And then like the other people, that are not possessed, they just look fine. Like their backs are completely straight. I don't know. It just looks weird. They just look really weird to me. Okay. No! Oh my god. Please. No! Oh my god. They have 10 HP, so you can hit them, but you won't, but yeah. That's very bad, but yeah, it's actually a bad thing. They can do harm to you, and if you feel like they're in your way, then I guess you can kill them to get them out of your way, but trust me, it's not worth killing them at all. Ugh. Anyway, so we have a roller coaster. It actually, this looks funny. This looks funny to me when you're in 3D. Like, look at Mario when you're flipping to 3D. Or yeah, when you're doing this in 3D mode, it just looks really funny to me. It just sucks that Mario's the only character who has the ability to flip to 3D. So it's like you can't see Peach or Bowser like that either. I don't know. It just always looked funny to me whenever I ride this roller coaster or whenever I ride this bike cart. And just see myself riding a loop in 3D, in 3D mode. It just always looks funny to me. Maybe that's just me. But yeah. Anyway, so we have to go back now. One of these pipes we can actually enter in Super Mario Bros. But I'm pretty sure we can't do that. Okay, yeah, we can. That's kind of a shame. Oh, we can. Okay. Is it gonna be like in Super Mario Brothers where? Oh no, it's not. Okay, well, let's see what we got going on here. Hey, we have a cool area. Okay, we have a chest. Okay, let's see what it contains. In this case, a shroom shake. Wow, goody. Okay, let's go ahead and get rid of. Why do I have a lot of healing items now? Like. A few videos ago, during 5-1, I got myself destroyed in 5-1, and then now all of a sudden, I start getting, like, packed with items. Like, how ironic is that? Jesus Christ. Alright, so we have to actually go, bad grammar. We have to go back to Flint Cracknon now. I guess I'll meet you guys. Oh, actually, we're back here anyway, so no, I will not see you guys back, because we're not exactly back here. We just gotta make our way back up, like this. And it's very tedious, but yeah. I'm surprised that we actually went through this level really quickly. Because I remember this level taking me a very long time on my old playthroughs. With danger nibbling our heels, we venture deeper into the forbidden cave. To do so, we use the key to the last unopened door in the forsaken labyrinth. So you do have the key, right? Let me grab that. You never gave key. Really? What key? Uh-oh, did you guys lose the key? Yes, genius, a key. Wait, don't tell me you don't have it either. Uh-oh. I had key, but... Ah, yes, so you do have it. Good show. No, bro, I had the key. There's a difference between had and have, you know? Uh-oh, looks like the key has been lost. Well then, we're stuck. We will never rescue the Cragnons now. See, Craggly say, you lose this, so Craggly hold on to it. Craggly got key, brah. Propestrous. If such a claim were true, there would be evidence in my pocket, which there isn't. What? Whoa! Oh my god, it's right there! You had it the entire time. It looks like the long lost key had returned to your pocket. No, you probably just had it the entire time. Craggly, it's the space key, huh? Yeah, totally, right in pocket. Fingers, brah. Yeah, serious, big surprise. Lucky events finding that key. I'm sure everyone contributes somehow.
Now onward, we must make our way to the last unopened door, to the horror depths. If my research is correct, and it always is, but then this key should open that door. Of course, through the door may lie a trap that will devour us all. Ho 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 ho. Tremendous, such bravery!
I was planning on opening up myself, of course, but since you seem so passionate, not that I'm afraid or anything, don't be ridiculous. I mean, that's laughable. As a fellow crag trotter, I know the heavenly thrill of the hunt. I cannot read the rest of it because I'm going too fast in the dialogue for whatever reason, because I'm not patient. But yeah, see you in 2 ticks. Okay, 2 ticks, you say? That's fine. Okay, tick one, tick two, 2 ticks. Boom. Did we do it? I don't know. My TV just muted. I don't know why. My TV has been doing some really weird things lately. I think there's a ghost possessing this TV. I'm really serious. Like, you can't see it in the display because, oh my god, now it's changing the channel, and then now it's turning off. See, I don't know what's going on now. Because that is definitely not my doing at all. Nothing is touching the remote right now. I have the TV remote right next to me, and there's nothing touching it at all. So I don't know what is going on. I don't know if there's a ghost in the house that's like possessing this TV, but it really, really messes with everything, especially when I'm doing streams. Anyway, right in the final minecart, which is a shame because I love this minecart. It is this is like the best part of the chapter in my opinion. It's my favorite part. I just love this minecart. It just makes me happy whenever I'm doing this level. All right. Oh my god. And the TV just turned off. Thankfully, nothing bad happened. Okay, hit this block right here, and then we have a mega star. Oh baby. Alright, well then, it's time to destroy them all! I forget what the line was in Billy and Mandy, where Billy was afraid of something, and so he just kept yelling some phrase, and it lasted throughout the credits of the episode, and it was hilarious. I believe it was like... Man, I wish I can remember. Whoa, lag. Lag spike. That was really weird. Aww, nothing special here. That's a shame. Oh well. If you flip the 3D mode, there are some Kragnons. So be careful. I can probably show right now. Yeah, there's like some. Thankfully none of them were in the way, otherwise we'd be losing the points, and that's not good. And yeah, I guess, since I just said it now, that's what they do if you kill them. So, alright then. Well, anyway, enough said. End of chapter!